We live in a world in which information about things appears more abundant than ever before. So much so that it taxes the mind's ability to contain it all. Now, if you look up the definition of knowledge, you will find something like this. Facts, information, and skills acquired through experience or education. And if you dig deeper, you will come up with jewels like this, speculative meetings. Quote, knowledge is an abstract concept without any reference to the tangible world. Students, try and tell that to your parents when they're paying your tuition fees. Oh, daddy, fees are just an abstract concept. Yeah, sure. But let me cite another definition of knowledge, this time from the Bhagavad Gita, the most authoritative text on yoga and its purpose. Now, this definition of knowledge will revolutionize your understanding of both contemporary knowledge and traditionally understood knowledge. I will cite two of the five Sanskrit verses from the 13th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. Amanitvam adambitvam ahimsa shantir arjavam acharyopasamam saucham stairam atma vinigraha indyarte shubhairagyam anahankara evacha janma mrityu jara vyadhi dukkha doshan udarshanam. Now, please listen to the translation. Humility, non-violence, tolerance, simplicity, accepting the guru, cleanliness, self-control, absence of false ego, the perception of the evil of birth, death, old age, and disease, detachment from the world, even-mindedness amidst pleasant and unpleasant events, practicing bhakti yoga, accepting the importance of self-realization, and the philosophical search for the absolute truth. Krishna says, all these I declare to be knowledge, and beside this, whatever there may be, is ignorance. Well, that's an eye-opener, isn't it? Did you learn any or even some of these things in school or at home, like humility? How about accepting the importance of self-realization? Generally, these topics just don't fit into our mundane definition of knowledge. We're more interested in things like artificial intelligence or how to impress others with the way that we dress. And that is because we learn today is all about what we are. But the definition of the Gita is all about who we are. And that's a big difference. And according to spiritual authorities like the Bhagavad Gita, what's important in life is who you are, and what you are is just a detail. Whether you're a scientist, a doctor, a lawyer, or anything, what you are is basically about putting a roof over your family's head. And to highlight what life is all about, the Gita calls all the knowledge to get to your diploma ignorance. It's ignorance, especially in comparison to real knowledge, and especially if what you are totally eclipses who you are. So youth, before you embark on a profession, make sure you learn the items listed in the Bhagavad Gita. And those already beyond youth, supplement your current information bank with real knowledge. Humanity, with all its so-called knowledge, has driven our world over the brink of destruction in a competition for further materialistic technological know-how. In the process, we have lost our souls, completely neglecting our personal development, who we are, and what the purpose of life is really all about. My request? Please nourish your souls by discovering the truths and teachings of the Bhagavad Gita as it is, especially from someone who has realized those teachings, not from some fake. That is what knowledge is all about.